Friends, welcome to virtual class 4 of physics. Today we are going to discuss about electric flux. What is electric flux? Before understanding this, we need to know what is a normal or area vector. Anything that is perpendicular to a plane is said to be a normal vector. Either the plane is horizontal or vertical. Normal vector is always perpendicular to this. For a curved surface like a sphere, if we consider a point on this plane, normal of a sphere or a circle is always passing through its center. So normal for this is this vector. If we consider a cylinder, how many surfaces are there? This is first surface, the curved surface is second one, and again this is the third surface. For this surface, normal vector will be this one. For this surface, normal vector will be like this. And for the curved surface at any point, normal at this point, area vector or normal vector will be like this, at this point, like this. So these are the possible cases which we are going to study to understand the logic of electric flux. Now, let us discuss about the electric flux. What electric flux is? Number of field lines passing or crossing a given area. So the flux is nothing but phi is equal to B dot A. This A and B are both vector quantities, and the resultant of these is a scalar, which is phi is equal to B A cos theta. Let us assume this is our normal vector or area vector. Sorry, not B, it's E. Number of field lines. And this is our electric field vector, and this is angle theta. So the angle made between normal vector and electric field vector is theta. So from this we can conclude that the dot product of E and normal vector is equal to the electric flux, which is a scalar quantity, and unit of this is electric field Newton per coulomb multiplied by area. So SI unit of flux is Newton meter square per coulomb. Next, for continuous for continuous distribution of charge, we can write phi is equal to integration E dot ds. This is also we can called as electric flux. Now let us consider an example in which we need to calculate total flux. In this situation, we can consider three surfaces and the direction of electric field is from left to right. The electric field is uniform throughout. So, to calculate the electric flux, let us assume normal vector for this is in this direction, for this surface in this direction, and for the curved surface in this direction. We are considering three surfaces, first, second, and third. Now, the total flux phi will be equal to integration E dot ds due to first surface plus E dot ds due to second surface and E dot ds due to third surface. As we can see that the direction of electric field and normal vector n in the first case is electric field and area vector are at 180 degree. So here we can write E ds cos 180 degree plus second region electric field and normal vector are mutually perpendicular. So we can write E ds cos 90. In third region electric field and normal vector are in same direction. So we can write E ds cos 0 degree. If we integrate ds, we can get a, which is equal to e into a, and cos 180 is minus 1. So we can write it as ea. Eds cos 90 is 0 and it is simply ea. So the total flux will comes out to be 0. In this way we can calculate electric flux for any curve. Thank you.